some Campbells out there watching this shit right now, they're like shaking their head right now. I ain't trying to disappoint. A lot of the stuff is totally like, it's Cambodian food, but it's like Cambodian like summer barbecue sort of vibe.
Set it up.
You can grab that.
I mean, I'm gonna be out here cooking for a minute.
This guy right here, he's one of my best friends right here. Every time we do this show, it's always different, like whether it's in a living room setting or whether it's in like a cool venue in you know, some city or in a college campus. We just want people to like be able to connect with like our stories, whether it's through the poetry or through the food.
So tonight, y'all, I need to cook. I need to take something dead, massage it in adobo, let it get loose to the song of oil and sweat, and watch it give life to those that eat it. Tonight, we will eat. Tonight, we will praise over our food and not worry about the language we do it in. Tonight, the stereotype of being Latino and loud does not exist here.
I had never cooked until a year ago, maybe a year and a half. I remember writing it down and I was like, damn. I have this idea. I really hope that Ricky likes it because I feel like it's a really good idea. And I remember I called you. I told you like we would do poems and like and cook at the same time, blah, blah. What do you think? And then there was a silence. And I'm like, damn, he doesn't like it. And he's like, yeah, it sounds cool. I think that'll be really good. I think it'll be fun. Yeah, that'll be pretty cool. I lived in Puerto Rico for like 2-3 years. And when I came back, I had certain culture that I had certain things that I did that the rest of the Puerto Ricans that lived here didn't, and I felt very ashamed for it. I'm very thankful of coming where I come from, you know, Lowell, Massachusetts, 978 Mill City in the building all day, every day, you know what I'm saying? And I wouldn't have changed it. I wouldn't change it for nothing, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to where you come from, even if at the time you didn't like it, you know what I'm saying?
But there was a youth program in Lowell where people were getting together and learning poetry and spoken word. And Thibo was running that workshop, that group.
It was my first year. I had no idea what I was doing.
Thibo was like my mentor, and just being involved in like poetry, meeting other young people from around Lowell, was just like really like fun. It was like really crucial at like the time being like 16, 17 year old.
It grew from that mentor mentee to that like colleague and friend that like I trust Ricky wholeheartedly to do anything. Like whenever I can't do a gig, I always like my first person that I think of is Ricky.
I want on the cloth of your body, there's no sound to you except your mouth. I want the syllables of your name to be the vote for my tongue, but you are nameless. Without soul, a ghost living here, you are dead to me.
Food is also like a very personal experience, like very hands-on. Like you make food to feed yourself or to feed someone that you care about, you know. We feel like it's important to sort of like use spoken word and poetry as a tool for like learning and developing yourself.
So if things go well, we could possibly have a full spring of going on tour across the country doing this show.
This is the twerk rotation on this egg. It's superb right now. It's getting crispy over here.